Hi everyone! V-Ray 5.1 is released and here are some cool new features I am sure you will love. I have opened this bedroom scene, which is the example I am using in my Udemy course. If you are interested, please click the link in this video description. Let me first say that as far as the rendering settings are concerned, nothing has changed. We are using everything we have said so far for V-Ray 5. Let me press F10 to go to the Render Setup dialog box and choose V-Ray 5 Update 1. We are keeping all the default settings and let me go to the Render Elements tab and add V-Ray Denoiser and V-Ray Light Mix. And let's now see the new stuff. If we take a look at the V-Ray toolbar, we have some new buttons. Let me start with the Cosmos browser. Click on this button over here and the Chaos Cosmos browser opens. Mainly, we have two menus, the 3D models and the HDRIs. You can also see here the Creators menu, which is basically a combo of the first two. Let's explore first the 3D models. Let me go to the accessories and you can either choose a category or see all models here. I will go to the tableware and food and choose those oranges. Once I leave the cursor over a preview, we see the download button, but we can also click on the preview and see its properties. So this model is offered by Design Connected and it is approximately 23 MB. Click on the download button. You can see the progress here. And here it informs us that the asset has successfully downloaded and we can now import it. I will simply click and drag it in the scene. When we import it, our object remains selected. It's good to go and rename it. And why is that? Because if we deselect it and try to select it again, sometimes it works and sometimes it doesn't. Let me also go to the top view and try it here as well. Why is this happening? Because the objects we merge from Cosmos are proxy. How can we solve this issue? As I started telling you earlier, when we first import the object, it is good to go and rename it. Now I can press H and easily find it here. I will go to its properties and in the proxy parameters rollout, in the display section, choose Show Whole Mesh. And now, no matter where I click, it gets selected. Let me move this on the coffee table. Something is wrong with its angle, so let me rotate it and place it properly. Let's do a crop render. See how it looks? Perfect. And we didn't have to load any textures, everything is set for us. Let me import one more object just to make sure the steps are clear. Open the Cosmos browser. Go to the lighting menu and choose this pendant. If I drag and drop it in the camera viewport, you see that it gets an odd orientation. while if I delete it and drag and drop it in the top viewport, we're all good. Because in the camera viewport, it can't really understand how it should be aligned. So it's best if you do that in the top view to avoid having to adjust your object later on. Rename it and choose Show Whole Mesh. Let's do another crop render. This is also perfect. If you want to change the finishes, open the Material Editor, choose the Pick Material from Object command, and click on the object. This is a multi-sub object, and we have already seen how we can adjust this type of materials. One last thing here. If we want to change the dimensions of this object and, let's say, increase the height, if I select it and go to the Modify tab, here it says Proxy. What we need to do is click on the modifier list, select Edit Poly. So now I can choose Vertex, select this part, and push it lower. Disable Vertex, and we're all good. Be careful to also move the very light that comes with it. Let me click one more time in the Cosmos browser. If I click here, so downloaded only, we can see the models we have downloaded so far. Let's now go to the HDRIs menu and to our top view. Download the HDRIs you like and simply drag and drop them. We can drag more than one. And let me close this. Let me also select the V-Ray Sun and disable it. And hide this plane, just to be sure that it doesn't block the sun. And let's render the full viewport now. I know that I now have three dome lights and all of them are enabled, which is wrong. But if you recall, in the render setup window, we added V-Ray Light Mix. So now we can go to the Layers tab, click on Source Light Mix, choose Light Mix, and here you see the three HDRIs. What we can do is disable all the lights by clicking on All and enable the first HDRI. Now disable this and enable the next one. Now disable this one and enable the next one, and so on. Instead of disabling and enabling, we can hold the Alt key and the light source we click on gets enabled and the previous one gets disabled automatically. So this is a really great time saver. That's all with the Cosmos browser, and let me show you one more cool new feature we have in V-Ray 5.1. We have this new button, the V-Ray Camera Lister. If we click on it, we can see a list of all the cameras in our scene. This is a great time saver as well. Before that, when we wanted to adjust a camera, we needed to select the respective camera, go to its properties in the Modify tab, and adjust the settings. Now, we have the properties of all the cameras in one single panel. Let's say that this is a similar philosophy to V-Ray Light Mix, where we can control all the lights in one panel. Now we have the same for our cameras. That's all for now on V-Ray 5.1. I may come back with extra information. Till then, enjoy this new release!